In our other videos, we talked about the basics of fine-tuning a language model with TensorFlow. And as always, when I refer to videos, I'll link them below. Still, can we do better? So here's the code from our model fine-tuning video, and while it works, we could definitely tweak a couple of things. By far the most important thing is the learning rate. In this video, we'll talk about how to change it, which will make your training much more consistently successful. In fact, really there are two things we want to change about the default learning rate for Adam. So the first thing we want to change is that it's way too high for our models. By default, Adam uses a learning rate of 10 to the minus 3, 1e minus 3, and that's very high for training transformer models. We're going to start at 5 by 10 to the minus 5, 5e minus 5, which is 20 times lower than the default. And secondly, we don't just want a constant learning rate. We can get even better performance if we decay the learning rate down to a tiny value, or even to zero over the course of training. So that's what this thing here, this polynomial decay schedule, is doing. So I'll show you what that decay looks like in a second. But first we need to tell the scheduler how long training is going to be so that it decays at the right speed. And that's what this code here is doing. We're computing how many mini-batches the model is going to see over its entire training run, which is the length of the training set. And then we multiply that by the number of epochs to get the total number of batches across the whole training run. Once we know how many training steps we're taking, we just pass all of that information to the scheduler and we're ready to go. So what does the polynomial decay schedule actually look like? Well, it looks like this. It starts at 5e minus 5, which means 5 times 10 to the minus 5, and then it decays down at a constant rate until it hits zero right at the very end of training. So I can already hear you yelling at your monitor though, and yes, I know, this is actually constant or linear decay, and I know the name is polynomial and you're feeling cheated that you were promised a polynomial and you haven't gotten it. So calm down though, it's okay. Because, of course, linear functions are just first-order special cases of the general polynomial functions. And if you tweak the options to this class, you can get a truly polynomial, a higher-order decay schedule. But this linear schedule will work fine for us for now. We don't actually need all those fancy tweaks and fancy gadgets. So, coming back, how do we actually use this learning rate schedule once we've created it? So it's simple, we just pass it to Adam. So the first time when we compiled the model, we just passed the string Adam to get our optimizer. So Keras recognizes the names of common optimizers and loss functions if you pass them as strings. So it saves time to do that if you only want the default settings. But now we're professional machine learners and that salary review is upcoming. So we've got our very own learning rate schedule and we're going to do things properly. So the first thing we do is we import the optimizer. And then we initialize it with the scheduler, which is getting passed to the learning rate argument of that optimizer. Now we compile the model with this new optimizer, and again, whatever loss function you want. So this is going to be sparse categorical cross entropy, if you're following along from the fine tuning video. And then we're ready to go. Now we have a high performance model ready for training. All that remains is to fit the model just like we did before. Remember, because we compiled the model with the new optimizer and the new learning rate schedule, we actually don't need to change anything at all when we call fit. We just call it again with exactly the same command as before, but now we get beautiful training with a nice smooth learning rate decay, starting from a good value and decaying down to zero.